lived together. We shared a flat in West London for about a year, and we were just sort of keen to do something together, to work together in some way. And we had a few ideas which sort of went out the window. And then one day I think we were just watching telly, and we just sort of said, why don't we do an animated band? And little light bulbs appeared above our heads, and sort of off we went, really. Just sort of got into it straight away, and started off we sat and talked all night and just came up with loads of ideas, and suddenly realised sort of how much potential it had, how far it could go, and all the fun things we could do with it. I think we laughed a lot, and then the next morning I sort of woke up and started drawing.
Yeah, I'm speaking for you here, but I think, sort of hanging around Jamie, I kind of sort of got into this, you know, the relative anonymity that he enjoys, you know. Like, we'd go out to a party and no one would know who he was until he sort of said, oh, what do you do? I created this character, Tank Girl, you know, and I thought that was really cool that you could exist on these two tiers. And so I kind of started gravitating to the whole idea that I could do what I love doing, but in a very different context. And from my point of view, that's how we sort of got around to that sort of conversation. And then we really left it at that, and I kind of went into my studio and Jamie went into his, and we sort of started doing what we do, but not really considering what the other one was doing too much. In fact, I think that would have been a real hindrance if we'd have got caught up with kind of trying to make everything match. I mean, I just went off and made a record which I'd always wanted to make, in a way which I'd always wanted to work, in the sense of not really knowing from one day to another what was going to happen, and just working with musicians that you know, you just don't get access to if you're in a sort of the band that the Blur is and was.
We have studios in the same building, so it's like you said, we're not sort of constantly sort of making sure everything fits together, but you know, at least once or twice a day we're sort of hanging out in each other's space, sort of just seeing what's going on. But it's the best way of working, is I get on with my bit, he gets on with his bit, and every now and then it sort of overlaps, and he comes and throws ideas in, and I go down and get on the piano, plonk out a few tunes, and it works that way.
Yeah, I've got about 75% of the record finished, and it was very eclectic at that point, and probably didn't really make any sense. And I've never really been able to produce records. I'm good at sort of putting all the raw material in there, but sort of focusing it, I've never been that adept at. So I kind of talked to him on the phone about the idea of what we were trying to achieve, and he sort of, without hearing a note, flew over, and we spent a couple of weeks in London sort of really focusing all these tracks. Because, I mean, at that point, I'd written all the songs, and I put a lot of the overdubs on. But for one, there wasn't any rap on Clint Eastwood or Rock the House, and he got Del involved. And the song 19-2000, which I always felt had a sort of Tom Tom Club flavour to it, he got Tina Weymouth involved. And I suppose the only little kind of sort of area where we really sort of tried to make the two gel was with Miho being the sort of the voice in an abstract way of Noodle. And so we've just started kind of honing down all of this eclectic stuff, and my hip hop beats were kind of at the least very naive, and he sort of made them a bit kind of harder and sort of, do you know what I mean? That's the kind of the way it worked. There was no really any plan. It was just like, this is what you've got, sort of see what you can do with it. And then once we'd finished the record, in that way, I hadn't put any vocals on, and I hadn't really written or finished off a lot of the vocals, so we decided on Jamaica for 2 months to sort of hang out, and our work rate kind of decreased, you know, almost to non-existent. But in a way, it was kind of, that was really important to get some optimism into it, because there's a tendency in the winter months in Britain to make very dark music, and I think we went sort of late spring to Jamaica, and the whole thing had the necessary colour put into it. You know, if you're going to work with animation, it's got to be, you know, got to be quite colourful.